हैप्पी हिंदू न्यू ईयर। आप सोच रहे होंगे कि 13th अप्रैल को ये लड़का हैप्पी न्यू ईयर क्यों विश कर रहा है, और फिर से हिंदू, क्या ये हिंदू हिंदू लगा रखा है यार। और वैसे भी साल के बीच में ये कौन सा न्यू ईयर होता है, हा? सब बकवास है ये सब मैं नहीं कह रहा हूं। दिस इज बिलीव्ड बाय द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ इंडियन यूथ टूडे।
पीपल ओनली रिकॉग्नाइज गुड़ी पाड़वा और युगादी एज मियरली अ हिंदू फेस्टिवल, बट दे आर कंप्लीटली ऑब्लिवियस टू द रीजन why it is also celebrated as the start of the new year according to the lunisolar Hindu calendar system. Our festivals correspond to the ancient Indian calendar and they are closely related to the astronomical phenomena. In today's time, India follows the Gregorian calendar, which is fundamentally a calendar based on Christian tradition. In the next few minutes, let's try to understand the concept of a new year in Hindu as well as the Gregorian calendar. The Gregorian calendar is a derivative of the Julian calendar, which is again a derivative of the ancient Roman lunar calendar. In the ancient Roman calendar, the year began on the new moon before the spring equinox. The spring or the vernal equinox point is one of the four cardinal positions of the earth in its orbit around the sun. On the day of an equinox, the duration of night and day is roughly equal, and hence the name equinox, where nox means night.
The ancient Roman calendar was originally a lunar calendar based on the lunations. The ancient Roman calendar, however, was an undercorrected calendar as it measured only 10 months, starting from March and ending in December. This calendar was later modified by Emperor Numa in 753 BCE. He added two more months to the ancient Roman calendar as the 11th and 12th month as Januarius and Februarius, along with the provision of intercalary months to keep it in sync with the seasons. Julius Caesar in 49 BCE dumped the lunar calendar and installed a solar calendar. Julius Caesar thought it would be appropriate for January, Janus's namesake month, to be the doorway to a new year. And when he created the Julian calendar, he made January 1 the first day of the year.
In ancient Roman religion and myth, Janus is the god of beginnings, gates, transitions, time, duality, doorways, passages, frames, and endings. He is usually depicted as having two faces, where one face looks back at the past and the other looks to the future. Since then, January 1 was adopted to represent the start of the new year. Pope Gregory acknowledged 1st of January as the beginning of the new year according to his papal bull of 1582 Inter Gravissimas that introduced what became known as the Gregorian calendar, which we use even to this day. So why is today celebrated as the new year's day in the Indian subcontinent?
India has an ancient tradition of following different types of Hindu calendars. The Hindu calendar refers to a set of various lunisolar calendars that are traditionally used in the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia, with further regional variations for social and Hindu religious purposes. Of the various regional calendars, the most studied and known Hindu calendars are the Shalivahana Shaka, found in the Deccan region of southern India, Vikram Samvat, found in Nepal, north and central regions of India, and the Tamil calendar used in Tamil Nadu, all of which emphasizes the lunar cycle. Their new year starts in spring. In contrast, in regions such as Kerala, the solar cycle is emphasized, and this is called the Malayalam calendar. Their new year starts in autumn. So today's day is celebrated as New Year's Day, popularly by the Konkani Hindus, the Telugu Hindus, and the Kannada Hindus. It is called Gudi Padwa in Maharashtra and Ugadi or Yugadi by the people in Karnataka. So what exactly happens on Gudi Padwa astronomically for it to be celebrated as a new year?
In a lunar or lunisolar calendar, the duration of a month depends on the lunations. There are two types of lunisolar calendars, the Purnimanta and the Amavasyanta. In the Purnimanta, a month ends with a Purnima, while in the Amavasyanta system, it ends with an Amavasya. The Amavasyanta system was predominantly used in many regions of India. In Amavasyanta system, a month is measured between two successive new moons and there is one full moon between two successive new moons. Hence, in the Amavasyanta system, the nakshatra in which the full moon of that month appears is used for naming that month. So the month in which the full moon occurs in Chitra nakshatra was named Chaitra. The month in which the full moon occurred in Magha nakshatra was called Magh, and so on. The first month of the Hindu calendar Amavasyanta system, which is predominantly followed across India, is considered as Chaitra. The name of the month implies that the full moon in the month of Chaitra occurs when the moon is in Chitra nakshatra. Since the full moon occurs in Chitra, the preceding new moon will occur about 180 degrees opposite to this nakshatra. This preceding new moon is the Falguni Amavasya, or the last day of the year in the Amavasyanta system, because Falgun is the last month.
After the Falguni Amavasya, the first Tithi or the Pratipada in the Shukla Paksha of the month of Chaitra occurs near Ashwini Nakshatra, and this signifies the start of a new month and a new year. But then you might ask, what is so special about Chaitra for it to be treated as the first month? The reason behind this is astronomical, and it relates to the position of the sun.
The transition of sun into the first point of Aries or Mesha was of particular importance in the past, because this point once coincided with the vernal equinox point or the Vasanta Sampad Bindu, which denoted the start of the spring season. Hence, this transition of the sun into Aries was also called Mesha Sankranti, and it was considered as the end of winter and the beginning of the spring, and hence also the beginning of the new year. When the sun enters the Mesha Rashi or the first point of Aries, the corresponding full moon will be in Chitra Nakshatra, that is 180 degrees opposite to the first point of Aries. And as we discussed above, when the full moon of Chaitra will be in Chitra, the first day of that month occurs when the moon enters Ashwini Nakshatra in the Mesha Rashi. But since our calendar is based on the moon, we consider the entry of the moon into Mesha and not the entry of the sun into Mesha. And this is how Gudi Padwa occurs on the Pratipada of the Shukla Paksha of the Chaitra Masa. And hence, it is celebrated as the start of the Hindu New Year.
So even though Gudi Padwa is celebrated as a festival, there is also an underlying astronomical reason behind celebrating this festival which we should know about. So once again, happy Gudi Padwa and happy Hindu New Year. If you found this video informative, then follow our page Satyalok on Instagram and help us to spread the culture of ancient India with as many people as possible. Stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthana Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat. Tera kita 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 tera k